On July 12th, La Casa Azul Bookstore had their annual celebration commemorating Frida Kahlo's birthday.
El evento de hoy fue el tercer aniversario del evento anual en que celebramos la vida de Frida en su cumpleaños. Los primeros dos años tuvimos un concurso donde las personas podían venir vestidas idénticas a Frida, que vinieran con representación de cómo se vestía Frida durante su vida. Pero este año decidimos hacer algo un poco diferente, en que les ofrecemos a las personas que vienen a que nos digan si Frida viviera en Nueva York en el 2014, cómo se vestiría, cómo llegaría a la Casa Azul, en cómo actuaría, y fue como un take más moderno a la tradición anual que tenemos aquí.
Frida Kahlo was a Mexican artist that lived during 1907 to 1954. Frida began painting as a child. After a train handlebar penetrated her stomach and broke her spine, Frida was left bedridden for a long time, and her father encouraged her to paint. Frida's father placed both a canvas and a mirror right by her bed, initiating her journey as an artist and giving birth to the first string of famous Frida self-portraits. Apart from being an artist, Frida was also a feminist Latin American woman proud of Mexico's indigenous traditions. Many forget that Frida, along with many Mexican artists at the time, were very critical political thinkers and commentators. Today, Frida and her unapologetic look at women's experiences in the world, our happiness, suffering, and sexuality are celebrated throughout. She was able to show the world emotions and experiences many of us are still taught to hide to this day. In honor of Frida, let us not only remember her work as an artist, but also allow her feminist footsteps to guide us in our own work.
Womanhood, unapologetic womanhood and femininity, being a force to be reckoned with and not being willing to apologize for it, and using her personal experiences and validating them and saying, this is who I am, and that's important enough to be put on canvas and to have people see it. And so I feel like she's just been an important representative for women, for artists, for Latinas in general, in that sense, because oftentimes our stories are not told.
Para mí personalmente, Frida Kahlo fue una mujer revolucionaria, una artista y una mujer que amó mucho, y amó a la vida, no solamente a Diego Rivera, pero a su vida y lo que ella experienció cuando vivía en México.
¿Y este evento a qué se dedica?
Este evento se dedica a celebrar a Frida Kahlo, pero con la comunidad. Entonces, es traer a la comunidad para que aprendan algo de Frida Kahlo si no saben todavía.
So the twist was that it had to be modern, right? So I figured that Frida might not wear skirts anymore because of the time period that we're in now. And also that she might wear a lot of color still, a lot of jewelry. She often had a unibrow, she painted herself with a unibrow, so I wore that today. I brought a cigarette because there's a lot of pictures of her smoking. I have a Diego tattoo. Because she loved Diego Rivera, she was married to him. And I just dressed in a way that I thought was funky and original because that's what she would wear.
Estudiar la vida de Frida Kahlo en la universidad, yo supe más de la vida de ella, de su experiencia como artista, como persona y como una mujer mexicana, y me ha inspirado bastante. Y siendo yo también de origen mexicano, se me hizo algo perfecto en una manera de honrarla a ella, honrar a la cultura de mis raíces mexicanas. Y el vestido yo creo que representa para mí, igual que las mujeres que estaban aquí, la continuación de honrar a Frida con un diseño y con la influencia de Frida.